The already tough job of managing the Senate might be about to get harder for the Turnbull government. Tensions are boiling in Pauline Hanson's One Nation, with two of the party's four senators engaged in open warfare and sending messages to each other through the media. From Canberra, political reporter Caitlin Gribben.
Starved of time with his leader,
I'm queuing up for a sausage sizzle.
Rod Culleton sought solace at a charity barbecue. This political drama has it all. A former Prime Minister.
Good, thank you. How are you going?
Not too bad.
A rogue senator.
Well, as you know, I'm sort of a little bit allergic to rules.
A chief of staff emerging from the shadows.
I will not be intimidated.
And an appeal via the media.
Rod. Excuse me, I'm party leader. I expect you to come to my office, right?
Rod Culleton, it seems, can't stay out of the spotlight. His election to the Senate's being examined by the High Court, and Queensland police are investigating whether he attempted to threaten a judicial officer over a letter he sent to a Queensland magistrate. One Nation leader Pauline Hanson wanted to meet yesterday about that latest issue. But the West Australian didn't show up.
Have you spoken with Rod Culleton today?
We haven't been able to organise a time to speak.
Well, he's right here. He's right behind you.
Are you disappointed that...
They finally talked this afternoon, but One Nation is barely being held together.
She's a party leader and she's a woman and she's a mother and she's very caring. And she cares about her team. And that's very comforting too.
One Nation so far has been fairly reliable for the government. But if that block of four shatters, it will make the coalition's job of getting legislation through the Senate even harder. And observers are keen to point out One Nation's fractured history. The party split after the 1998 Queensland election, where it picked up 11 seats. Six MPs quit that year, and One Nation soon lost its political party status in the state.
Cheers!
But Pauline Hanson is back, and One Nation support is growing in Queensland and Western Australia, where elections are looming, and the coalition fears that despite today's travails, the way is clear for her to pick up a swag of state seats. Caitlin Gribben, ABC News, Canberra.